Good morning, everyone. It's Tess, and it's tip 129. And again, I'm looking at Harvard Health, and they had an article. Actually, they have a program they're trying to get people to sign up for. But they had an article about discovering simple techniques to help experience deeper joy, cheerful contentment, and long-term happiness. And I just thought it was kind of ironic because I actually have been doing work with like Unlimited and Zahara Mahoon, and today's actual affirmation has to do with we all deserve to feel good. So I thought I would kind of share this article because I've had a few people kind of tell me lately that they've been depressed or not feeling good. And I know that happens for all of us and we all have those moments. And if there are a few tools that might help us along the way, it's not a bad thing. And like I said, Harvard Health Positive Psychology School actually is putting a program together. So if it's enough of an issue that they're putting a program together, we all face it from time to time. And what it kind of first started off with, and I'll say this is what I'm even learning with Zahara Mahoon and Unlimited, is that happiness is a choice. We either choose, and I know it sounds simple, but we either choose to think happy thoughts or we choose to think sad, stressed, or anxious thoughts. It's kind of like the law of attraction emotional scale. Where are we focusing our energy? Are we trying to shift to positive thoughts or are we shifting to negative thoughts? And I've had a lot of time to think about that in the past year, and I find that it's so much more helpful when I recognize that my thinking patterns might be going in the wrong direction. What they're talking about is that they created an all new positive psychology course. Again, I didn't take the program, but a lot of what I did read in the article is very similar to what we've been learning in Doc V's group or what I've been learning in the Unlimited group. And what it has to do with is they talk about trying to get into a happiness zone. You know, kind of think about things that will make you feel good. Sorry, I have a cat walking in the window this morning, if you hear the clink, clink, clink. But so you kind of find things that might make you happy. Is there a picture, you know, in old days, I used to have a voice recording of my niece and nephew or my goddaughter when they were real little. So if I was having a bad day, I would listen to the voice, or having pictures, a vision board with just nature on it. Things that kind of make you feel good. If you have them positioned somewhere, it kind of reminds you that there's something to be grateful for and something to be happy for. The other thing they talk about, and I think this is true too, is when you have too many things, too many choices, sometimes that can cause you anxiety and unhappiness and cause you to be lower, where you're anxious and depressed and upset. So that might be something to kind of control too. Hi, Rachel, how are you? So it does talk about being in the happiness flow. And what you want to do is remember, being in the happiness flow, I know this sounds simple, but they say it's about a choice. And I would use tools like vision boards with nature or things that are important to you that can help you shift when you're feeling that. Music, videos in the background, I am affirmations, or but something that will make you think, praying, gratitude. The other thing they talked about in this is that the too many choices, and sometimes you can get into analysis paralysis by having too many choices. So sometimes it's, and this, they talk about this in a lot of programs too. If you're trying to change your life, spending too much time analyzing choices doesn't allow you the momentum to move forward. So sometimes it's just better about making a choice and moving forward, not getting drowned in a lot of facts. Oh, sure, Rachel, thank you. Then it also says letting go of envy, grudges, and resentments, and I think that's important too. We're all going to have frustrations. We're all going to have people that make us crazy. We're all going to have moments where maybe anger flares up, but the quicker we can learn to release it and move on, the better off we are. Because kind of what we've all found out is that if you carry anger, resentment, disappointment, and you're directing it at someone else, it doesn't hurt them, it just hurts us. So we have to stop hurting ourselves, holding on to things that we have no control over. It goes right back to that same thing. The only person we can change is ourselves. So that's where we have to focus, changing ourselves. Developing resilience to handle difficult situations, being able to bounce back. And again, I think that's back to identifying tools that will help you. Can you take a walk to kind of let off steam? Can you write statements? Like I read recently that somebody writes, you know, life is meant to feel good, or I want to be happy today. Today is a good day. Just maybe even have a notebook and you just write those things down, back to music, back to pictures, whatever can kind of help you shift when your energy or anxiety starts to come back. It just helps to kind of remember that you can shift it and try to make it better, because I am hearing a lot of people say that lately, and it is changing. So if we can find little tools, that will be helpful. Another thing they do talk about is stop procrastination. Procrastination just puts another thing that causes us worry, stress, and anxiety. So if you can do something, just something, and get it off your list, it's one less thing that's staring you in the face. It's one less thing you're analyzing to figure out how you're going to fit it in. And that might relieve a little bit of stress. So instead of analyzing how to fit it in, just get it done to the best of your ability and move on. Increase your focus and alertness. I know I've kind of talked about that for me, how I do that is in watching how I'm eating, how I'm thinking, definitely, but we've kind of talked about that for the past few minutes. But the other part of it I do is in keeping clear by knowing that I'm fueling my body right with proper sleep, with proper water, with proper food. And that does help me with my attention. This one they said too, short circuit the anxiety caused by Facebook envy. And I imagine that is an issue with a lot of people. I don't suffer it anymore, but I don't want to compare myself to somebody else. My life has a different independent path, and I'll just end up unhappy if I try to make it mirror someone else's, because I wasn't put here to live the life that someone else has. So if we can let go of that kind of comparison thing, we're not keeping up with the Joneses, we all have a different path, it'll make us feel better. And then savor more pleasure in your life, and pleasure with the simple things. The simple things about finding a baby bunny or a flower, something simple, because if you start making the things that make you feel good high things, then you're not going to be able to grab on faster and realize that each day is a day to be enjoyed. Experience the warm glow of happiness. And I think that is so important, because if we focus and we keep thinking in that positive place, it kind of breeds around everyone else around us. It's not always easy. We do have areas of our life that we have to work on it harder. And for me, it's work, because I have certain expectations myself, and I have to control and manage that better, because I can spin myself somewhere where I don't want to be. And that is something that I have to work on, but we all have areas to work on. Enjoy happier, more resilient relationships with the help of, so they just kind of talk about, you know, and I think it's just connecting. We've had this past year and a half where we haven't been able to connect. So whether it's via a chat or a brief get together, just reaching out to someone that you haven't seen in a long time, because there's probably many relationships that have followed by the wayside due to what we've been going through this past year. So I just thought that was interesting. Harvard Health has actually put together a positive psychology course to try to help people get back into this. And I just figured I would mention it, because I have heard a few people talking about depression. And I know depression can come with loneliness. And I talked about loneliness a couple of days ago. And if we can start to kind of think about the things that might shift us, that could be a great tool. And just kind of quick and easy, remember, if you can shift your thoughts to happy, sometimes I'll write, you know, I want today to be a good day, I want to feel good today, so that I can try to get my mind to flow into it. And that's a lot like with the law of attraction, with the Zahar Mahoon and Unlimited. Reduce the number of choices and don't overanalyze to paralysis. Let go of resentment, envy, and judges. Try to be resilient in handling difficult situations. I know that's a hard one, but we can build skills. Stop procrastinating. Just do one thing so it's nothing, so that you can reduce the number of things hanging over your head. Gratitude. Gratitude and appreciation does help to bring you up higher, so that you're feeling places of joy and happiness. Increase your focus and alertness. I do that a lot with food, water, and trying to fuel my body in a healthy way, because that helps me to move forward. And then anxiety about trying to compare yourself with someone else. We were not created equal. We were not meant to be equal. Comparing with somebody else, or and in a lot of cases, they're finding out too. All those people that have the beautiful life on Facebook, sometimes it's just a picture of something that really they don't own. So why are we comparing ourselves and trying to live up to a standard that somebody may have created that's not really fake or that's not really real? So I hope you have a beautiful, beautiful day. And remember, if you start shifting low, just maybe start saying some positive thoughts to yourself, or play some positive music in the background. We all deserve to have a great day, and let's make them great. Let's let go of that negative self-talk and put ourselves somewhere happy. Thank you, and have a wonderful day.